Hello everybody, warm greetings on behalf of Sri Chaitanya School. Welcome back to the Smart Living Program, the most prestigious and unique initiative from Sri Chaitanya School, with the main objective of installing life skills in students. Here, let me tell what Smart Living Program stands for. S stands for self-discipline. M stands for moral responsibility. A stands for awareness of health. R stands for responsibility towards society. T stands for technological advancement. We aim at our students develop all these life skills to make them strong and better citizens for themselves and for the country. This time, we are going to concentrate on the patriotic spirit, which comes under social responsibility.
Greetings of the day and a very warm welcome to the fifth part of the Incredible India program under the Smart Living program for this month. We are trying to give you a knowledge of the national leaders who created a mark on the history of our struggle for independence. Last week, we knew about the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi. This week, let us know about a few more national leaders. Next to Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru has the predominant role in the most successful phase of the independence movement. Now, let us try to know something about him. Jawaharlal Nehru was born in Allahabad. He initiated into Theosophical Society at the age of 13 upon the guidance of their family friend Annie Besant. He went to Trinity College, Cambridge in October 1907 and graduated with honors degree in natural science in 1910. Next, he moved to London and studied law. He was called to the bar in 1912. He attended the annual session of the Congress in 1912. He supported Indian civil rights movement by Gandhiji in South Africa and collected funds. During World War I, he volunteered for St. John Ambulance and worked as one of the provincial secretaries of the organization in Allahabad. He, for some time, was involved with aggressive nationalist leaders who were demanding home rule for Indians. Nehru joined the movement and rose to become the secretary of Besant's Home Rule League. He led the non-cooperation movement in United Provinces. Even after the calling of the non-cooperation movement, he remained loyal to Gandhiji and did not join Swaraj Party. He played a leading role in the development of the internationalist outlook of the Indian independence struggle. In 1927, Nehru represented India and was elected to the Executive Council of the League Against Imperialism that was born at the meeting in Belgium. Nehru drafted the policies of the Congress and a future Indian nation in 1929. All these aims formed the core of the fundamental rights and the economic policy resolution drafted by Nehru in 1929-31 and were ratified in 1931 by the Congress Party session at Karachi chaired by Vallabhbhai Patel. Nehru assumed the presidency of the Congress Party during the Lahore session on 29th December 1929 and introduced a successful resolution calling for complete independence. He participated in Salt Satyagraha and was arrested on 14th April 1930 while on train from Allahabad to Raipur. Nehru considered the Salt Satyagraha the high watermark of his association with Gandhi. In the times of World War II, he insisted that India could only fight in support of Great Britain and France as a free country. At the 1936 Lucknow session, the Congress Party despite opposition from newly elected Nehru as the party president, agreed to contest the provincial elections to be held in 1937 under the Government of India Act 1935. Nehru was also given the responsibility of planning the economy of a future India and appointed the National Planning Commission in 1938 to help in framing such policies. In the times of World War II, Nehru agreed to cooperate the British if India will be given with full independence after the war. The British rejected it. In October 1940, Gandhi and Nehru, abandoning their original stand of supporting Britain, decided to launch a limited civil disobedience campaign in which leading advocates of Indian independence were selected to participate one by one. Nehru was arrested and sentenced to 4 years imprisonment. Following the Quit India resolution passed by the Congress Party in Bombay on 8th August 1942, the entire Congress Working Committee, including Gandhi and Nehru, was arrested and imprisoned. Nehru served as Prime Minister for 18 years, first as the interim Prime Minister and from 1950 as the Prime Minister of the Republic of India. At the age of 74, he died in 1964. This is all about Nehru. Now let us move on to Vallabhai Patel, who worked as the first Home Minister of Free India and had a deep respect along with Gandhi and Nehru in the Indian independence movement. Vallabhai Javer Bhai Patel was born in Gujarat. He was popularly known as Sardar Patel. Patel traveled to attend schools in Nadiad, Petlad and Borsad, living self-sufficiently with other boys. He harbored a plan to study to become a lawyer, work and save funds, travel to England and become a barrister. At the age of 36, he journeyed to England and enrolled at Middle Temple in London. Returning to India, Patel settled in Ahmedabad and became one of the city's most successful barristers. He got reputation as fierce and skilled lawyer. At the urging of his friends, Patel ran in the election for the post of Sanitation Commissioner of Ahmedabad in 1917 and won that election. In September 1917, Patel delivered a speech in Borsad encouraging Indians nationwide to sign Gandhi's petition demanding Swaraj, self-rule from Britain. Patel supported Gandhi's non-cooperation movement and toured the state to recruit more than 3 lakh members and raise over 1.5 million in funds. In Gujarat, he worked extensively in following years against alcoholism, untouchability and caste discrimination as well as for the empowerment of women. In April 1928, Patel returned to the independence struggle from his municipal duties in Ahmedabad when Bardoli suffered from a serious double predicament of a famine and a steep tax hike. It was by the women of Bardoli during the struggle and after the Indian National Congress victory in that area that Patel was first began to be referred to as Sardar. It means headman. Under the chairmanship of Sardar Patel, Fundamental Rights and Economic Policy Resolution was passed by the Congress in 1931. As Gandhi embarked on the Dandi Salt March, Patel was arrested in the village of Ras. Patel was elected President of Congress for its 1931 session in Karachi. Patel used his position as Congress president to organize the return of confiscated land to farmers in Gujarat. Upon the failure of the Round Table Conference in London, Gandhi and Patel were arrested in January 1932 when the struggle reopened and imprisoned in the Yerrawaddy Central Jail. Patel supported Nehru's decision to withdraw the Congress from central and provincial legislatures in the times of the World War II. He participated in Gandhi's call for individual disobedience and was arrested in 1940 and imprisoned for 9 months. He participated in the Quit India movement. He was arrested and was imprisoned with the entire Congress Working Committee from 1942 to 45 at the fort in Ahmednagar. When Patel was released on 15th June 1945, he realized that the British were preparing proposals to transfer power to India. Vallabhai Patel was one of the first Congress leaders to accept the partition of India as a solution to the rising Muslim separatist movement led by Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Patel represented India on the Partition Council, where he oversaw the division of public assets and selected the Indian Council of Ministers with Nehru. Patel took the lead in organizing relief and emergency supplies, establishing refugee camps and visiting the border areas with Pakistani leaders to encourage peace. As the first Home Minister, Patel played the key role in the integration of princely states into the Indian Federation. At the age of 75, he died in 1950. Let us conclude this week's presentation here and look forward to have another bout next week with the details of a few more prominent national leaders. Until then, have a nice time. Bye-bye.